Something was pouring from his mouth. He examined his sleeve. Blood? Blood. Crimson, copper-smelling blood. His blood. 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 And bits of sick. Greetings, traveller. I'm Garth Marenghi, horror writer. Most of you will probably know me already from my extensive canon of chillers, including Afterbirth, in which a mutated placenta attacks Bristol. Back in the 1980s, I wrote, directed and starred in Garth Marenghi's Darkplace, a television programme so radical, so risky, so dangerous, so goddamn crazy, that the so-called powers that be became too scared to show it, and jit me, much in the same way that women have done ever since they sniffed out my money. Only now, in the worst artistic drought in broadcast history, does the channel come crawling back, cap in hand and suitably ashamed, asking if your humble fabulist could once more retrieve Darkplace from the boxes in his spacious basement and let it loose on its unsuspecting public. That's you. Naturellement, I relented, and spent over 3 hours of my life knocking together some interviews with the key players in this historic programme, namely myself and my publisher, Dean Lerner. So, finally, here is Darkplace. For the first time on British television, it had a brief run in Peru. Sit back, dim the lights, or switch them off if you don't have dimmers, put conventional logic to one side, and enjoy. Well, I say enjoy.
Garth Marenghi, author, dreamweaver, visionary, plus actor. You are about to enter the world of my imagination. You are entering my dark place.
For the doctor's job. I can assure you my credentials are top notch. I've just graduated from Harvard College, Yale. I aced every semester and I got an A.
Well, that sounds excellent. Our last doctor only just recently died in horrific circumstances. Can you start immediately?
Sure. Do I have time to go to the toilet?
Not really. I've already paged Dr. Sanchez, who should be here any minute now.
I'm Dr. Sanchez. You're a woman.
Yes, I hope that's not a problem.
Not at all. There's plenty of scared on the wall. This is the 20th century after all, though some don't like to admit it. Welcome to Dark Place, Liz.
My hand!
I'm one of the few people you'll meet who've written more books than they've read. I felt I'd taken the novel as far as it could go. I guess it was inevitable that my imagination would make the move to television.
I got a script, read it, scared me senseless, calmed abitude, and I said to Garth, I looked straight into his face, I've never been afraid of holding a man's gaze, it's natural. I said, this is going to be the most significant television event since Quantum Leap. And I do not say that lightly.
My name is Dr. Rick Douglas, MD. I got the call too early to grab a shower, so I had to make do with a quick rinse around the key areas. Some little missy had taken a nosedive in reception, so Muggins was meant to haul us down there and kiss it better. But first, I had to visit a very special friend.
Is my daddy gonna be all right?
Your daddy is very sick, champ.
Is he going to die?
We're doing all we can. But I'm not Jesus Christ. I come to accept that now. I've got to get this. Son of a bitch. That's my boss. I've got to go.
They work you too hard here. They should pay you a hero's wage.
You're a good kid.
And you're a great doctor.
Never take drugs.
Dean's not an actor.
I warned Garth. I said, I'm not an actor. And he said, I'll always remember this, that he didn't want an act. He wanted the truth. So here is Dean Lerner playing Thornton Reed, not putting on an act, but putting on the truth.
Listen up, ladies. We've got a situation. A little lass has just cracked her nut. And if she croaks, my ass is grass.
That was Thornton Reed, my boss, head of the department, a ballbuster. But then he had to answer to Wanton.
She's here on the express say-so of Wanton, a star pupil, you might say, and one that Darkplace has high hopes for.
So far, we've given her some Lucien, and that seems to have helped, but she said she's having visions. Blood guts, a real horror show.
That's Dr. Lucien Sanchez, hotshot surgeon. He's a good buddy, though we sometimes have punch-ups.
Is that why you called me in? As far as I can tell, some dames just banged their bonds. Qu'est-ce que le diff?
Wait, I have more things to say.
Go on. Sorry for the interruption.
Don't mention it. She's saying there's something supernatural going on. It's witchy woman wittering and it wants nothing out of the wick. This is a place of science, after all. I need panic in the walls like I need a hole in the head.
Something supernatural, you say? That sounds bang up your alley, Dag. Aren't you an expert in the arcane and black arts?
That was a long time ago, Sanch. Got my finger span.
Well, it can count me out, Reed. It's all voodoo nonsense as far as this cat's concerned.
Fair enough. You take the reins on this one, Dag, but make sure your methods are orthodox.
Don't worry, Reed. This sounds routine. I'm sure nothing untoward will happen.
I hope he heeds my words about being with this in an orthodox manner.
He will. He's the best damn doctor on the wing, or any other wing for that matter.
He's a wild card.
But I'm glad he's in our deck.
Let's hope he plays a fair hand.
He'll come up, Trumps.
If it's not a joker in the pack. And sometimes there is.